A huge line visible from space. A giant mirror stretched from seashores through deserts to mountains. A garden city where cutting-edge architecture blends with the latest technology to become a true paradise. At first glance, we have either an excerpt from a futuristic novel or a description of a location in a video game. But this isn't Star Trek or Cyberpunk 2077. It's Arabia in the near future. Let's find out what it all is and how real it is. Saudi Arabia is one of the major powers in the Middle East, with a population of 36 million, a huge territory, and incredible fossil fuel resources. The black gold brought wealth to the kingdom, but also danger. The huge country is critically dependent on oil, its exports, and value. Actually, the leadership of the kingdom understands this very well and is trying to get rid of this dependence, diversify the economy, and create new advanced industries that could continue the development of the country in the future. The strategy in general is similar to the strategies of the other countries in the region, for example Egypt or the United Arab Emirates. Dubai, in this regard, is a shining example. The grand plan, called Saudi Vision 2030, was presented by Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman Al Saud in 2016 and includes a giant strategy for the country's multifaceted development in everything, from tourism and education to infrastructure and industry. We will not be describing everything. We are interested in one of the points. NEOM is a combination of the Greek neo, new, and the Arabic mustaqbal, the future. Well, or Mohammed, in honor of, in fact, the father of the project worth $500 billion, involving the creation from scratch of a futuristic city stretching over an area of 26,500 square kilometers in the province of Tabuk, on the border with Egypt and Jordan. The location was chosen appropriately since the Suez Canal is located nearby, which means that NEOM will be near the largest trade route, not a bad help for development. The main gems of the city should be the luxurious Trojena Resort, located in the mountains of the region to the east, a huge industrial zone, and a city of 90,000 inhabitants named Oxagon, due to its regular octagon shape, part of which will be located right on the water, as well as the object of our special attention. The line is by far the most ambitious item of the NEOM project. 170 kilometers or 110 miles line city, stretching from the Red Sea coast through deserts and mountains almost to Tabuk. In general, the history of linear cities is quite long. At least for the most of the 20th century, architects from different countries were putting forward the idea of creating such agglomerations, elongated in length with an axis on some transport route. But the line, having reproduced their concept, went further. We are talking about a pair of huge buildings stretched parallel to each other for the entire length of the city, located in between them. Well, not exactly in between. This pair of buildings should form a horizontal line at the level of the roofs at a height of as much as 500 meters above sea level, which means that even without counting the length, they will be full-fledged skyscrapers. Meanwhile, the distance between these skyscrapers will be 200 meters. Eventually, the city will not only be linear, but also vertical, hanging on this pair of buildings along the inner perimeter. Thanks to this configuration, the line will occupy 98% less area than the same city of a conventional type. Its area on the ground will be only 34 square kilometers. The result of this will be that most of the local areas will not be affected, and the impact on the environment will be minimal. At the same time, the issue of ecology is solved not only by this, but also by the fact that the vast majority of the energy consumed by the line will be obtained from renewable sources, and harmful emissions will be reduced to a minimum. The optimal temperature will be provided by both active and passive cooling measures. Light will penetrate into the interior of the complex from above. The entire infrastructure will be located in the same place, along the inner circuit, and the apartments on the outer one, overlooking the outside. The heat in them will be managed by special glazing, thanks to which the line from the outside looks like a giant mirror. How big should the city be? It is assumed that 9 million people will permanently live in the complex, a very serious figure. and given that the size of the city is very compressed, its population density will reach 260,000 per square kilometer. Just to understand, the population density of Manhattan is less than 30,000. In order to prevent a city with such a density from turning into an overpopulated ghetto, a whole range of measures has been developed. It will be divided into layers and sectors. At the upper level with open space, there will be residential areas. At the bottom, partially underground, auxiliary infrastructure will be located. And even lower, completely underground, transport lines. Moreover, given the length of the city, transport becomes a critical factor here and involves the creation of a high-speed railway line capable of delivering a passenger from end to end in just 20 minutes. The infrastructure, in addition to city personnel, is supposed to be managed by artificial intelligence. Meanwhile, the concept of zero environmental harm assumes that there will be no cars in the city at all. The sectors are full-fledged parts of the line, accommodating 80,000 people, and each sector takes into account all the necessary infrastructure, which can be reached on foot in 5 minutes. And all this in an almost ideal climate-controlled environment, surrounded by countless parks and the most advanced services. The project was announced personally by Prince Mohammed bin Salman in January of 2021. It is assumed that the construction of the entire city will cost about $200 billion. But the return is also expected to be serious. Hundreds of thousands of jobs, the emergence of new businesses, tens of billions of annual growth to Saudi Arabia's GDP from non-oil industries. The settlement of the first citizens is expected by 2024, and construction is planned to be complete by 2030. Although the huge cost of as much as $200 billion may still turn out to be underestimated, and according to some assessments, the final cost may end up being multiple times more. At this point, we can think about the problems. The line is probably the largest building project in the world right now. Saudi Arabia has gigantic financial resources, but to carry out such a massive development, they will need more than just money. Here we can recall the Jeddah Tower project, which has already turned into a half-forgotten, long-lasting construction. And the line is much more complicated in design and requires much more serious study than just a kilometer-high skyscraper. The second problem, oddly enough, is the problem of environmental impact. Here it is worth paying tribute to the project. Of all the options of creating a 9 million metropolis, the line nevertheless is the most green. However, it would be naive to think that it will not affect the environment in any way. At least we are talking about a 500-meter wall that cuts the entire region and its environment in half, not to mention the fact that all this still needs to be built. The third nuance is the concept itself. I have already said that the idea of a line city is not new, but as we can see, there are no such cities now. All projects have either been cancelled or such lines have eventually turned into ordinary districts. Even if the line is built, the question of infrastructure remains open. 260,000 inhabitants per square kilometer is an overwhelming burden, requiring logistics on a monstrous scale. They announced a high-speed railway with which people can travel the entire city in 20 minutes? It means that the speed of such a railway would have to exceed 500 kilometers per hour. Yes, now there are trains capable of reaching such speeds, but these are extremely expensive cruise models, and here there has to be an actual subway with dozens of stops. A challenge? Very much so. And it's the same with the vertical component. You need thousands of elevators or something like that to move such masses of people. Walking distance is good, but running up and down 20 floors can be a little tiring. And there are hundreds of such nuances. The creators say that those will be handled by the artificial intelligence that controls the city. Well, firstly, it also still needs to be created. And secondly, AI is a very promising and trendy topic. But let's be honest, it is not a universal remedy and cannot work by the logic, if there are problems, we will install a smart computer and it will sort everything out. Somehow. It is also worth considering that the line is not just a long city, but a city that is supposed to be built according to a single project, practically in one fell swoop. There were also such projects before, and alas, they often were not developing as originally planned. A city is not just a complex of buildings and roads, but a living organism that evolves along with its people. The line, no matter how much you calculate it, runs the risk of encountering the same problem. Will it in the end be really comfortable for life? Will it not be necessary to rebuild something in the finished building? And finally, where will it develop in the coming decades? Will its growth lead to an increase of length? Or will it, like many other lines, at some point simply begin to grow into residential areas along the perimeter? What looks great on a computer screen may not be so great in practice. It is simply impossible to take into account absolutely everything. Another factor is the social and political. NEOM is a region in Saudi Arabia, a country with its own specifics, which for a long time scared away foreigners, including companies and investors. No matter what kind of residential areas, parks and trains there may be in the line, they themselves cannot invent and create anything. You need to build an appropriate, attractive environment. And this task should no longer be solved by architects, but by politicians. From the point of view of technology and architecture, the line is an incredibly interesting project, and despite all the risks, I would like to hope that everything will work out. But its fathers will have to put serious effort into making the project a city from bright futuristic fantasy, and not a hive from creepy stories of gloomy future. And the city's fathers are staying busy. Despite all the apparent publicity of the project, the statements made by the authorities of Saudi Arabia are supported by real actions. The line is no longer just beautiful videos, but also a real construction site. Earthworks are already underway along the entire length of the foundation of the complex. Obviously, the line, like the entire NEOM project, is very important for the country and must be implemented. And how it shows itself in practice, we'll see. Like and subscribe to the channel. The line has reached the horizon, and there are still a lot of interesting things there.